Yeah.
So yeah, like I asked before, have you ever made or worked on a horror film?
Well, I suppose my longest short film that I made wasn't a horror film, but it was sort of suspenseful. Mm. It's called Ghost Girl.
Oh yeah, so, I remember you mentioning that. Yeah.
So I think it's available on an open link on Vimeo, and I did try and create quite a bit of suspense in that.
Yeah.
Even though the title's possibly slightly misleading, if you see it, you'll probably understand why.
Yeah.
It did have quite a few elements of.
One minute, Dave. Sorry.
It's all right. No problem. Sorry.
Are you the visitor that's downstairs?
Oh, I'm the visitor. Oh, sorry. Yes, I thought you'd been found to be sent, but obviously that was.
No, I've come to find her to tell her she got a visitor
downstairs.
Well,
yeah, I'm downstairs, but right. I'm back now. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Okay. Cool.
Okay. Yes. So.
Sorry about
that. So that film. That film was quite suspenseful, and I wanted to create, sort of a bit of an atmosphere of. Horror is not quite the right word, but sort of suspense.
As you say, the suspense is used in horror, so it's definitely.
And it was
beneficial.
using. It was her story really, but entering. She was in a blind man's house, and he obviously wasn't aware she was there.
Yeah.
So it was quite easy to create an atmosphere of suspense because, of course, the stuff that was going on around him. He didn't know what was causing it.
Right, okay.
So in effect, there was a little bit of a horror element in it, but not in terms of, not as much blood and guts and gore.
Yeah.
So, however, I have done stuff with prosthetics and makeup before. There was a bit of blood in that film, but it was just cuts and bruises rather than anything major. In terms of prosthetics that we've used, we did a during driving campaign an awful long time ago and had a lot of fun with fake blood, creating a dead person.
Right. Okay.
And drawing a sheet back from his head. And we had to do a lot of times because although he looked dead, he was very pale, very dead. Every time we pulled the sheet back, he'd be laughing. Or eating the blood. And it was great fun, but it looked really effective.
Yeah.
And I've always been quite drawn to that genre, even though I don't make a lot of films of that genre.
It's quite a difficult one, isn't it, really?
It is. I mean, I think creating that suspense and a lot of horror films that really do work don't necessarily have to go full out in terms of being gratuitous in the sort of physical aspect of it. To me, what I like is that sort of psychological suspense.
Yeah, same.
Which can be as effective. Like in American Horror Story series. A lot of the stuff that goes on there, some of it is obviously very weird.
Yeah.
But some of it is in your mind.
Yeah.
And the suspense is... It's created in a different way rather than gratuitous shock and horror. And the other interesting thing I did read about was when I was quite interested in how to put together that sort of horror is not the necessary cue with audio or sound effects to cue something happening. But it's really difficult to do because... It's used all the time. It's almost like a cue for our subconscious to go, uh-oh, something's going to happen, so let me get ready to be scared and then I'll be more scared. Whereas a lot of masters of horror have actually, or that genre, have got away from being, I suppose, cliched in how they approach it.
Yeah.
So, anyway, that's a long answer to a short question.
That's all right. That's fine. It's all beneficial.
Yeah.
Couple of things. How Ghost Girl, how successful was that movie that you did?
I got a lot of great feedback from it. It got an award at one festival, but I made it more of a sort of practice run for a feature, which I still haven't made yet, because I'd like to make that into a feature.
Yeah.
Probably won't be the first feature that I work on because I have other ones, but it will work as a feature. And it grew from being a short film